And UMI.
This is Rusty Russell Hopkinson and my name's Tim Rogers, and we're from UMI, and we've been battling with the self-imposed obscurity for so long, so in a cheap quest for fame, we're going to be playing bowl with Nathan Harvey.
Obscurity is not something Sydney band UMI were ever really destined for. Their performance at last year's Big Day Out impressed Sonic Youth Lee Renato so much, he invited them to America to produce their debut album, Sound As Ever. Juice magazine heralded the album as the debut disc of the year, and Rolling Stone called it one of the most exciting records ever to be released. As for the boys, they remain fairly philosophical about the whole thing.
You know, it sure beats working back at my pizza job. You know, I get to get drunk with, you know, my two best friends 300 nights of the year, you know, and play the kind of music that I always wanted to play. Are you still my friend?
Is it? Oh, yeah. If half of what I'm saying, think what I'm saying is true. Unlike more seasoned bands, UMI have a refreshingly down-to-earth approach.
What we were talking about, that self-loathing thing before, like, we've been reading interviews with, you know, all these big bands from the States, and they're kind of carrying on about how painful it is to be successful, you know, how painful it is to be young, white, and successful, and look, go back and work in an oil refinery, you know. It's, you know, it's such a charmed life, you know. And sure, there are crap things about it, but there's just too many good things about it to whinge about it.
Although they're more interested in playing good music than making good money, they don't see success as selling out.
It's more an immediate satisfaction than thinking long term. But, you know, when avoiding success, that's dumb, you know.
Yeah.
We just don't think we'll ever get it.
No, I think you could be wrong there, but anyway.
Rather than using personal angst as inspiration for their songs, UMI look elsewhere for material.
Maybe you're just trying to invent situations, or if you have a dream, write about it, or put yourself in someone else's shoes, you know. I could be you for a day, and I thought it'd be more interesting than someone going, you know, isn't my life crap, that girl doesn't like me, you know. You can just put it in a different situation. I don't think enough songwriters do that, you know. They write about themselves all the time, you know. What a drag. We're a songs band, you know, we like to write songs. We don't like to write things in just a particular style, and if we don't feel like using a grunty guitar, then we're not going to. So I guess that, you know, that what makes us the distraction from grunge.
I don't know, I just think we play our instruments and sort of jump around, and I don't think there's necessarily any sort of, like, I am going to be a big hot rock drummer and do all this groovy stuff. It's just like, I just want to play the songs and play them as well as they can be played and have a good time, you know.
Together with absent friend and bass player Andy Kent, these strangely normal, slightly existential guys will be playing around for a long time yet. If you do get the chance to see them live, here's how to impress them.
You know, I'd like to see someone dive with just a lot of flair and choreographed well, like it's like an array of move or something, rather than a Michael Ella move.
I think a slight bit of transvesticism works as well with stage diving.
Absolutely. It's always the good looking guys that always finish first.
Yeah.
He's too cute to be that good.